It's been a while since my last upload due to important matters. But for today's video, I'll show you my preferred ant species, or should I say, my best colony so far. One of the dream ant species of an ant keepers are the weaver ants, or scientifically known as Oecophylla smaragdina. Sadly, some parts of the globe, such as Europe, America, and Africa have no native weaver ants, although they can purchase it on the market, but the price is really expensive. Meet this beautiful queen. She is very visible to our eyes because of her size. Did you notice how the weaver ants are bigger compared to the other ant species? They have two castes of workers, the major workers that measures from 8 to 10 mm, while the minor workers are half of the size of the majors. Also, this colony is a lot of brood. They are so adorable, especially the new workers or the ants with the lightest color from all workers. One trivia, my first keeps were three weaver ant queens, but let's focus on the weaver ant queen 2. We witness when queen number 2 placed her first brood, the development of her eggs into larvae, and her egg layings that we accidentally witnessed before. We also captured a rare sight while she was weaving the silk of her larva inside the test tube. It's awesome to capture those moments, right? Now let's go back to this colony. This specific colony knows their keeper. Observe and you will be amazed to know how we came up to that conclusion. Weaver ants are living in trees and are known for their unique nest-building behavior where workers construct the nest by weaving the leaves together using the natural silks from their larvae. They usually thrive on plants and trees with medium to large leaves which have broad and flexible leaves for better weaving. But this weaver ant colony is very different from other ant species that I'm keeping. Even though it has a lot of workers which are minor and major workers, they didn't show any signs of frustration from their test tube nest. This test tube nest is their home for 7 months. That's why they created some strong silks all over their nest. I always leave water sources and sweet food beside their nest for them to not forage in distance, and decided to not enclose the setup with any cover because weaver ants love to clean their nest from time to time. It's amazing that they aren't living and foraging few foot away from their home and look for some trees nearby. Weaver ants are polygamous, or living in more than one nest. This colony produces satellite nests for storing some of their eggs and larvae. Instead of leaving, they weave their new setup like the original nest. Some ant species are aggressive. Ferns, for example, always give painful sting to their keepers. That's why those ant species needed a lot of patience. Weaver ants are also known to be aggressive and highly territorial. However, another incredible observation from my weaver ants is that they aren't attacking their keeper. Even if there are many unnatural disturbances on their surroundings, like whenever their keepers are cleaning or feeding them. They seem like to know their keeper, so they don't attack. But they are showing ferociousness when it comes to their prey. They can subdue it from all sides, stretching them out until its demise. Let's give them a roach. This roach was pre-destroyed, so it can't escape if the weaver ants suddenly lose some control. If this type of roach successfully escapes, it will be a serious pest in the keeper's home. As you can see, workers manage to overpower the roach. Where do you think the weaver ants place their prey between the two nests? Is it on the old nest or in their satellite nest? Try to guess. Weaver ants bought their prey in their satellite nest. but the size of its entrance is not wide enough to bring the food to their home. Then they carry their food to their old nest where a queen lives. Are you correct, guys? Another interesting information about these weaver ants is that the brood of this species can be eaten by humans because they're rich in fatty acid and protein. Some countries in Southeast Asia are considering weaver ants' eggs as delicacies. Unusual, but have you tried it? One important note, we gave them another test tube setup just in case they need another home for their brood. So, that's it! Thank you for watching, guys, and I hope you'll join us soon as we transfer them in a very cool terrarium. See ya!